every one of us has a makeup that God has put within us, that it's only specific and special to you, and no one else has that DNA. So learning to know and appreciate yourself is very, very important. The other part that we have to acknowledge and accept that our past is always present with us. The way we were raised up, the way we were taught, the thing we were made to believe as the only truth. You know, my son the other day spent time with my father, who's his grandfather, and my father told him, showering with cold water is good, it makes you become a strong man. And ever since we came from up country, he's been showering with cold water. What the statement that my son was told, he believed. So the people that you associate with really have actually built who you are today, your parent, your relative, your grandparent. So it's important to understand, how has my upbringing been and how was I raised up? And so you'll find it that the way we react possibly just come from the borrowed pattern in our past that is ingrained in our subconscious. And so being able to journal and write all these things down will give you a path out of that. The Bible says, a man, the heart is deep water, but a man of understanding draws it out. Only when you draw it out are you able to clean it. But you cannot draw it out unless you accept yourself and you're aware of who you are. If you ignore, the more you ignore the challenges that come in your life and the way you're triggered, the more your path to danger comes along the way, and eventually you will suffer for it. So ignorance is not the best thing. You need to find a path, understand self, and seek for healing that is needed. And apart from that, so it calls for us to face our challenges. You got to go back deep into the heart, draw it out. And what happened? You manage this moment. How do you manage the broken heart? How do you manage the broken relationship? It is by a lot of seeking for advice and understanding why this particular issue moments come to be. For as iron sharpens iron, so one man sharpens another. And that's where we come in as well as life coaches, to help you to be able to overcome and to stand firm in the Lord, in your faith, in your Christianity. And you know, you're going to have one who walks with the wise man becomes wise. You're gathering a good company. And I will tell a single person like yesterday, if you don't like the group of people you walk with today, trust me, you're going to change it, because those are the people you will marry tomorrow. So you ask me, who are your friends? Who are my friends? I will tell you the person I will become tomorrow. My friend will bring an impact. And that's why it's important into the future to start building good and clear friendships. Apart from that, the kind of books we read, the kind of movies we watch, they determine who we become tomorrow. So it's significantly important to seek to understand, what path do I want to take? Who do I want to be? Please allow us to help you. That's where life coaching really comes in. Thank you.